thank you, Derek. And I just wanted to, in addition to thanking the OPAL-RT team, Wallace Arregio from OPAL-RT, and Ali Nababi from the University of Toronto. University of Toronto team and eCanyon are very close collaborators on the technology. And what I'm going to be talking about today is the app, in this case, application, the application we have of some of the simulation tools that eCanyon has been working on for close to 2 years now. But really, the project started just over a year and a half ago. And it started with a concept where we would take energy storage, which represents the DNA of eCanyon, which we've customarily used to integrate with the utilities and provide a very specific use case. In this case, it is a battery electric vehicle-based fast charging. And I just want to give the audience a little bit of insight as to what the eCanyon strategy is and how we've achieved that and where we're going in the future. So again, my name is Rick Sinchuk. I lead the technical development team at eCanyon. We're a small company located in the Toronto, Canada area, about 10 years old, a team of about 20 people that have been focused for the most of our existence on supportive utilities here in Toronto, some of the Detroit area, really in support of the utility end of the business, so providing arbitrage, grid support. What we have adapted, again, over the last year and a half to 2 years is a technology that leverages energy storage to provide a fast charging service to electric vehicle customers. And really, our contribution is to provide electric vehicle customers a fast charging experience where the utilities or the facility's ability to deliver is constrained, either through infrastructure or cost. And in many cases, customers are demanding tens or we expect soon to be hundreds of kilowatts of power where the facility is unable to provide that. One of the first use cases, the very public use cases across the Trans-Canada Highway, where the amount of grid space, grid power capability is relatively limited. And we are developing 150 kilowatts of power distributed across three dispensers in order to provide that service, which would ordinarily not be possible. So as I go through the eCanyon technology, and I'm just going to go to the next slide here. I look at the core components of the technology, and it's really three fundamental building blocks. We have the energy storage, which is lithium-ion-based energy storage, very similar to what you'd see in a car. Nickel, manganese, cobalt is in particular the chemistry we've focused on. And again, that is stationary power. It is for the most part, in our case, it's all air-cooled, fairly standardized chemistry with eCanyon's internally developed packaging, battery management systems. And you can see one of the embodiments we have here, energy storage. It's a small container. It's about 8 feet long by about 5 feet wide, maybe 4 feet, 5 feet tall. That's the energy storage component. The next component in our technology is the DC to DC power conversion. And so if you take a stationary battery like eCanyon's, and we have the approximately 600 volts of DC, that needs to be adapted to the particular customer. And the example customer here I'll talk about in a minute needs to go through a conversion step. And some of the simulation tools, the knowledge that we have closely collaborated with our University of Toronto team, certainly through the tools that OPAL-RT have made available to our academic colleagues, is that power conversion. So the ability to provide high power, isolated power to provide electric vehicle service and ultimately a product that electric vehicle customers can use is absolutely core to our ability to solve that problem. And the last, although it's called here a bus charger adaptability, is really the dispensing. We have one variant here that takes an inverted pentagraph bus charging example and provides that dispensing product to our customers. And so the application I referred to with the Trans-Canada Highway uses a combo charging system or a CHAdeMO charging system type of dispenser. This particular case, it happens to be a bus charger. So really those three elements are what comprises the eCanyon technology. If I look at the first element, the energy storage, that is foundational to ECAM's technology. We've got a couple of embodiments that are deployed in the field. One is on the left here is a pull top. That's a relatively small amount of energy storage, relatively low voltage, in the order of 20 to 30 to 40 kilowatt hours, and the voltage is typically around the 240 volt, again, bidirectional service, providing a service that, in our case, the Toronto Hydro organization, to address some of the life cycle concerns for distribution transformers. On the right is energy storage that is of the order of 250 to 500 kilowatts, bidirectional power capability for various utilities, again, across here in Ontario and the Michigan area. Again, foundational technology with energy storage. The second element that I refer to is the power electronics. So this is the conversion technology, air-cooled DC to DC, relatively high voltages, so 600 volts DC on the energy storage side. On the vehicle side, we're anywhere from 500 to 1,000 volts. We're modular. We have just been approved from our partners with United Laboratories, and our local electrical safety authority have supported our designs. We have a wide variety of inputs and outputs. We use off-the-shelf type components, so commercially available components to integrate that solution. The key here is the simulation tools were really the first step in being able to choose the different conversion strategies, the magnetics, and all of the elements that turn this thing into a, in this case, a successful product. As we look to the future, we will build on this platform to provide higher and higher levels of power and energy storage capability to meet what we believe to be higher and higher level of power requirements from electric vehicle customers as adoption rates continue to increase in the future. And, of course, the charging standards, the current applicable standards I referred to, the J1772, are the governing standards for vehicles. The bus standard is nicknamed J3105. That is a standard that will be released likely later this year. Our strategy is to use the energy storage and conversion and adapt to the evolving standards requirements to meet a number of different use cases. As we summarize this whole package up, we have what starts as a very simple container, energy storage and power conversion integrated together. We have a charging kiosk remote to the standard or remote to the energy storage and conversion where customer sites are capacity constrained. We have a number of different service options, anywhere from 10 to 150 kilowatts of service. Bidirectional is possible, and we have the ability to communicate via cellular or local networks to provide support. Again, from a safety standpoint, UL and ESA have been strong partners with us, as have our academic and simulation colleagues, and able to execute this product, which is now just being rolled out in the marketplace. So again, that concludes my update. I know there'll be a Q&A session shortly after.
Okay, thank you, Rick. Always interesting to see, you know, from simulation to application and how far you've come. So thank you very much for that.